Hello, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known as Brightshine. I live right here in the city of Memphis, in the state of Tennessee, in the countyship. But today's date is early Sunday morning, August 3rd, 2015, 2 a.m. And first of all, I want to say thank you to all my fans, my support for the continued encouragement and support. Continue to keep myself employed right here in the tri-state area. And chapter out of ministry right in the south of Mississippi. And I'll continue to further my education at Monroe College Online, pursuing my associate's degree in business administration with concentration marketing. And we're going to continue to talk about African traditional religion nonstop. And like I said, on today's video, just want to take just a few moments reading some as you know, okay, let me see what's up. It's I'm looking at the African Growth and Opportunity Act. And what that is legislation that has been approved by the U.S. Congress in year 2000. And it says that the purpose of this legislation is to assist the economies of sub-Saharan Africa and to improve economic relations between the United States and the region. Now, and for the countries in sub-Saharan Africa to be eligible for the African Growth and Opportunity Act on an annual basis, a country will have to improve their labor rights and movement toward a market-based economy. So, the sins of. still, I will read it says that the African Growth and Opportunity Act, it provides trade preferences for quota and duty-free entry into the United States for certain goods, expand the benefits under the generalized system of preferences program. In the African Growth Opportunity Act, it expanded market access for textile and apparel goods into the United States for eligible countries, though many other goods are also included. It comes up for renewal, and you know, this legislation, it was voted in, but it comes up for renewal in certain amount of years. So, being that it's beneficial to Sub-Saharan Africa, and you know, it is the law. We should encourage elected officials to renew this African Growth and Opportunity Act, and not only renew it, but also, if needed, update, because technology, you know, continues to make new and new products, things these next. So for that reason, when you renew the African Growth and Opportunity Act, you have to always include that you update the African Growth and Opportunity Act. For that reason, is that, you know, you have new inventions, or new technology, new techniques, and how to do things in this nation. So we are, for that reason, you have to update. You just don't keep renewing the same act. But back in 2000, year 2000, there's a lot of technology that's in 2015 that wasn't out in 2000 when they passed the law. There are new techniques that are being used that was not being used in 2000 when they first enacted the African Growth and Opportunity Act. So we're hoping that our elected official but not forget that techniques get updated, technology get updated, products get, you know, improved. And for that reason, you know, we are Don't leave that part out. While we encourage elected officials to pass the African Voting Opportunity Act. We don't want the elected officials to forget that they're important. I had a video I was sent, being that I was had the opportunity to be off, and I wrote on the All African People's Revolutionary Party. As you know, it's Women's Day. And the All African Women's Revolutionary Unit, which is part of, which is the same All African People's Revolutionary Party. But what they did is they wanted to make some, it was specifically done, you know, for training purposes and things like that, the All African Women's Revolutionary Unit going to start. And they sent me an email. And the emails, they sent me a video of the Women's Day activities and things. And so I had been, before I did this video, I had been watching that and was very interested. And they also has sent me some more information. And the Black Lives Movement and Black Lives Matter, African Lives Matter, things that actually was going on, and the activities that, you know, things that are taking place and being involved in, here it is 2015, and still having the have these type of rallies and marches and you know, activities such as this that like I said, you know, here it is 2015, and they can get out, you know, having marches, having rallies, protests, white police up. Or, in some cases, like they had the case up there in up north, where we had an incident, we had more than one incident, where a black female driver at night knocked on somebody's door. Trying to get some help in there. There was a white person in the house. They took a gun and murdered this young lady. But she wasn't the only one that happened to her. They had the young man down in the East Coast. I just seen someone today. Where he went to somebody's house trying to get some help. But they ended up, I think they called the police. And then the police came there and they killed him. But that was one of the reasons. It was late night. He went to somebody, knocked on somebody's door. And the people called the police. The police killed him. I think they all had a trial. I have to go back and look. If I ain't mistaken, I think. They didn't say they all dismissed the charge or something. I could look it up, but everybody that's just, you know what I'm talking about. The case, the police officer shot the young man. African American driver. It was at night. He went to somebody's house trying to get some help. The car for some help or something like that. And the people called the police, and he ended up getting killed by the police. That's not the only case. There's a whole lot of cases just like that. And just like that young lady up there, up north. The people who pulled the trigger, being white, They don't even come to court. Prosecutor turns off. Don't even consider. Charging. Then everybody gets out on the street. And march, protest, make up slogans. And then you got to sit around and wait for the Justice Department, for the state government, they intentionally do the same thing that the local government do. Don't press charges. So the federal government had to come behind the state government, like they did in the Trayvon Martin case. When the state of Florida went past, when they were in charge of the murder of George Zimmerman, the federal government picked the case up. And that's what's been happening in a lot of these cases, is that the local government and the state government not even pressing charges. But the federal government end up pressing charges. Not saying they're going to get a conviction. They ain't getting no conviction in the Trayvon Martin case. They'll never give up. They'll never quit. They're trying to be too long. But that's mainly what I want to talk about on this video is the African growth and Opportunity Act. And then it's up for renewal. And there are a lot of good things about this legislation. You know, it's always good for him too. You know, he always gonna be for the day. You know, but getting in contact with the local official, with the elected officials, and encourage them to renew this legislation. We be long live, when I get that visit, I said, John Henry, call me. He didn't even feel watch. So get finished with this video here. Then we'll watch one of these John Henry Clark videos. Then we'll I'll watch one of these Nigerian movies and go to sleep. And again, my name is Eric D. Johnson. Also known as Backshire. I live right here in the city of Memphis, in the state of Tennessee, in the county of Shelby. And again, I want to say thank you all out there and my support for your continued encouragement and support. And like I said before, I get in contact with local officials, encourage them to support the to renew the African Growth and Opportunity Act. And we hope they we keep it up with new improvements and we keep it updated. And also, if we get the opportunity to go on YouTube, it's a very interesting video. All African People's Revolutionary Party on Women's Day 2015, the All African Women's Revolutionary Union made a video and have the opportunity to watch the video. And until next time, I wish each and every one of you the very best. Take care of yourself and